Oh my God. The misery had to go, and the countless days of misery. I remember the Nationals, man, getting down that motherfucker. I remember getting a fucking, they lost my bag. I remember getting to the airport. I was so fucking weak.
Last night, I remember.
So hungry, yep. So weak. That whole week, I boiled a 10-ounce piece of chicken, and that's all I ate for a week. Off that 10-ounce piece of chicken, just picked, because I had to get 198. I just picked, you know, just when I just couldn't stand it no more. I remember
seeing you the day that I was pre-judging. I'm like, there ain't no way that motherfucker 198. I'm looking at you and I'm like, man, that's bullshit, man. They let the motherfucker go light heavyweight. That motherfucker ain't no light heavyweight. I was like, there ain't no way, man.
Hell yeah.
Because you was probably, what, 215 on stage?
217.
Yeah.
I weighed right in at 198 and a quarter. That fucking next morning, 217, I walked in for pre-judging.
Yeah. I was looking at him. I was like, so I only weighed like maybe 219, 220. I'm like, that motherfucker weighed as much as I do, if not more. Like, that's bullshit. How the fuck you do that?
Yep.
Come on.
You never go in the gym. Well, I'm not going to say never, but you try not to go in the gym without a goal, you know? I definitely try to train, you know, with goals every chance I get. You know, you have a little downtime here and there where you're not specifically knowing what you want to do with yourself. Maybe a little confused or whatever, depending on what's going on in life, you know? But, you know, overall, you never want to go to the gym if it's possible and not have a goal for yourself or your body. You know, whether it's a weight goal, whether it's a change, whether it's a weight goal, or whether, you know, it's a, you don't want to change the body part, you know, enhance it, you know, or, you know, if it's overwhelming, you know, bring all the body parts up so it'll match it. You know, whatever the goal is, you know, you want to find it and kind of establish, you know, to get in and out of the gym. If not, you end up just, you know, training in a circle.
Yeah. Hey.
Go to fucking work.
Yep. Yep. Yep.
Awesome. Come on. Come on.
Yep.
Yeah, light. Oh.
Yep.
Yep. Come on now. Yep, tight.
Yep.
Yep. Yep. Yep. Yep. Come on. Come on. Yep. 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 Yeah, you couldn't tell him shit. So with that, motivation is lost pretty quick. And people wonder why, you know, I've been motivated all these years and continue to be motivated. Well, that's one of the reasons why. It's because, like I said, I try to, you know, pick at myself as much as possible. Pick out a goal. Pick out so many weeks, you know, reasonably. to accomplish this goal. So, you know, that first week of it may be a little hard, you know, because you don't see the results right away. But within the 2-3 week range, you start seeing somewhat of a difference in whatever goal you set out for yourself. And that helps motivate you as well, you know. So being goal oriented is really, really important.
It works. Yeah. Come on. Solid. Come on. Yep. Come on. Beautiful. Come on. Fucking Jerry.
Let him do his one. And help keep you motivated. But myself and Branch One right now, we're trying to concentrate a little bit on, it's kind of strange for me to say, but there's a specific reason behind it, is upper chest, you know. And we've been doing a lot of floor presses. We added floor presses to the repertoire. We've done it before with Josh Bryant, doing the powerlifting, and that's usually a powerlifting movement that the powerlifters or the powerlifters use to help strengthen the top end of our bench or the lockout. Some people may not know is it does more than that. You know, it helps you concentrate, you know, also on that explosion, on that, you know, have you lost it, the gain back, that explosion in that middle to lockout, pressing movement, you know. Due to some circumstances, that's one of the things that we have to focus on, and that's why we added floor presses in, because it's a great exercise. It's one of the exercises that I've done over the years, and I have accomplished what I wanted to accomplish in doing it. So I'm pretty excited for these next, you know, 6 to 7 weeks. We're going to concentrate on it. And every chest day, every Monday, we're going to add floor presses on. We'll get more in specifics later. We just added it in, so we want to see the results of it here in the next week or two. And then we'll share more with you on, you know, why, exactly why we, you know, chose it as a goal. But if you want to enhance your bench, if you, like I said, you need got a, that's the sticking point for you during your bench press is mid the lockout, then that's the exercises, that's the exercise you want to, you know, start performing on you know, every week during chest day.
Some fucking pressure on. Come on. Yeah. 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 Come on. Come on. Come on. Let's go. Yeah. I would say light now, but this motherfucker ain't light. Come on. Finish it. No matter what. No matter what. Yeah. Let's go. Yeah. Come on. Yeah, time.
two. Come on, Johnny. Lock my squeeze.
Hard too, because I just grabbed the motherfucker. This fucking handle, if it was steady, it'd be a little bit better. I can make these one.
Good. Good.
Fuck, you got the whole goddamn.
Fuck, you awful bitch.
Holy shit, Batman. God damn, there's no rest for the weary. Let's go. Come on. Yep, to the wheels fall off, baby.